Many people ask me how we stand out amongst all of our competition, and the easiest answer is, what competition?
These are very important things that are too often overlooked, and many times the very things that destroy a company when you don't even know that you're not doing them well.
So they don't try to pretend to be something, they simply are who they are.
One thing many people might not speak about is that the military gave me an exceptional eye for detail.
And even though the home's only 3 years old, we replaced the entire roof, all the metal, all the flashing details.
Because I care. And people typically want to do business with people they can tell care.
On this episode of Roofing Insights, we're bringing you all the way to Charlotte, North Carolina to meet our friend Jordan Cox. Jordan represents military in business. I absolutely love my military business owners, my veterans. There's so many in the roofing industry who have been in the army, have that army discipline. Now they apply the discipline in business, and Jordan Cox represents exactly that in the roofing business. He built already $5 million business, just started in 2016, took him 5 years, and we will show you how he did it.
My name is Jordan Cox, and I'm the owner of Roof Medic. Roof Medic was started in 2016, and it came about through a passion of helping people. After working with another local roofing company, I recognized all the things a good roofing company needed. Since then, it's been about finding like-minded individuals that share my passion for helping people, and the rest is history. So I'm the product of a single parent upbringing. I witnessed how much work it takes to be successful and create a happy home. However, it was my military background and subsequent deployments to Afghanistan that gave me the tactical foresight I believe I have now.
Jordan already have reached that milestone that so many roofing business owners trying to reach, $5 million a year mark. It takes a lot of discipline, a lot of focus, and a lot of hard work. It's not where you advertise, it's not one or two things, it's combinations. Like he said, it's building a team of like-minded individuals. Hard work truly pays off in the roofing business, but above them all, you just have to be focused and disciplined.
This homeowner, very, very beautiful custom home, is only 3 years old. One of the better landmarks of this home is the roof and the roofing detail. So he had a pretty big issue to the right side of the conical roof near that valley and that curved flashing, that curved counter flashing. A project of this scope took us about a week and a half to perform.
The roofing business is very simple. Do what you say you will do, roughly when you say you're going to do it, and communicate very well throughout that process. If you can do those simple things and you're good with numbers, you should be successful. One of the biggest things that the military gave me to that end were right place, right time, right uniform.
My first question is, I see two welcome floor mats. One is by GAF and one by Certainteed. Is that two brands you install?
Those are the two brands that we've come to trust over the years. I have no problem hanging my hat on either one of their brands, their materials, and their warranties. They've all proven to stand the test of time for us. We are GAF Master Lead accredited, and we have recently attained a Presidential Club Award. We have strived to receive every award or certificate that they offer. And it's that pursuit of knowledge that allows us to be passionate in our education aspect. Many people ask me how we stand out amongst all of our competition, and the easiest answer is, what competition? Because there's not that much when you get to that point, when you pursue those achievements and those awards. The last time I looked, I believe there was about 265 registered roofing companies in Charlotte. The numbers that matter to me are, how many of those are licensed? How many of those have great ratings?
Is license required here?
License is not a requirement here. And this is the trickery. There's a lot of people that simply don't know that it's not a requirement. They believe that, how can somebody work and do this without a license?
I absolutely love that little rant that Jordan just gave us. What competition? And it's so true. I travel to companies all over the country almost every week. Despite the fact that the roofing market is saturated with roofers, if you keep learning on a daily basis, if you keep getting certifications, and if you have this drive for perfection, you're not gonna have competition. If you're gonna be a top 3%, everybody else will be below, or majority of the contractors will be below you, in the sense of homeowners will not be considering them because there's not many master elites, platinums, master installers by biggest brands, but also well-branded companies like Roofmatic. You can't do that in the fast food or restaurant business. It's much harder, but in the roofing business, it's doable.
Coming from the military, the advantages I got were being a non-commissioned officer. I understood what good leadership was in relation to bad leadership. I understood prioritization. I understood timeliness. These are very important things that are too often overlooked. And many times the very things that destroy a company when you don't even know that you're not doing them well. One thing many people might not speak about is that the military gave me an exceptional eye for detail. And I will state that my Sergeant Major McWhorter from the 3rd Brigade gave me an unrealistic amount of detail with our room inspections. When it comes to Certainteed, of course, the landmarks are sold the most, but what we love to sell are the Belmonts. It's a beautiful mix of, you know, a premium at a not killer price, and the Presidential. The Presidential probably more so than the Belmont. But one of the things I like most about them is they do so little marketing. So they don't try to pretend to be something. They simply are who they are. And that's noted when you look at them. Everybody knows this. They focus on their internal quality, their production, the tightness of their production guidelines and quality metrics. The shingle weight is a big thing for them. So crews don't love it as much, but we pay them a little bit more when we do install those premium shingles because the weight is just, there's a big difference between Certainteed and many other brands. So while I was in the military, I was an Army medic. So I had a combat medic. I deployed twice, and I have been quoted as being, the name Roof Medic came from a Vietnam veteran that I was servicing right down the road while I was still with the other company. He told me one day that I was his roof medic and that he was so thankful that he met me. And the name kind of lingered because it meant so much to me. When I found theroofmedic.com that was available, it just seemed to make sense.
Roofmatic is just another great example how brand name matters. When you have a name that people can recognize, can remember, you know, it's just a recipe for success moving on. Because if you have a bad name, we talked a lot about on this channel, people are not going to remember you even if you do good work. So Roofmatic have that in place.
Roofmatic is located in Mint Hill, North Carolina. Though we service the greater Charlotte area, Mint Hill is very much our home. It is known as the Purple Heart capital of North Carolina. We have a lot of military families, veteran families, service members that live throughout and around this area. So it's a very part and part is very much, resonates very much with who I am. There is a line where it's simply smart business. If you're doing one or two builds a month in a small company, one owner, he's a sales guy, he's doing production, his wife's answering the phone calls or something like that, it's logistically difficult to then coordinate all of these things. And it's adding extra steps in your day and the cost benefit's not really there. But as soon as your company gets to the point to where you have teams, like a production team. So we have a production manager and we have project managers. Okay. So our production manager, me and him, I coordinated what should this look like? Where should things go and what's the flow? That's why up here, these are most of our everyday materials. Button caps, ridge vent, our metal trim coil, we use Master CO MP1, step flashing, everything that's everyday occurrence right here. So when this bay opens, you know exactly where your stuff's at.
I see so many startup roofing contractors are debating whether they should rent warehouse space or keep working out of their home. And the reality is, if you want to grow your business, if you want to save money, you need to start buying stuff in bulk. 2021 was a great example of shortages, nails, underlayments, shingles, starters. Roofmatic does it the way I love to do it, the way I've been doing it in my business for years. Stock those materials, organize them. You will be saving $1,000-$1,500 a week if you're doing one roof a week, because numbers don't lie and it adds up. Before you know it, you're saving $200 per job five times a week. That's your $1,000 a week in savings. Will pay way more for that warehouse. You know, average warehouse cost about $1,500 to $2,000 a month. You do the math. But you have to have some volume. I would say if you already passed $1 million in annual sales, you should get a warehouse.
We've got this on site. We've got our safety cones out. They've got the locks. We've got our wood, our drippage, our caulk, our paint, our button cap nails, our brake machine, anything excess, ridge vent, all the tools necessary, chargers, batteries, extra wood. It's here. This singularly was the first step we did where we actually noticed. You've got a commanding presence of your brand image on the side, placed right in front of the project. This is your chance to perform for the community. You've got a clean loadout of materials so that you've got less people leaving, coming and going throughout the day, less running around between project managers and sales guys. I would say due to the demographic of Charlotte, you know, they're a very money friendly city. And there's a lot of educated people. I mean, every town, I believe, has had their share of storm chasers and people looking to know, well, how can I get my roof approved? So we have an exorbitant amount of phone calls that are focused on the insurance claims aspect, wind damage, storm damage. But how we get these calls, I would say most notably, they're from referrals and our strong reviews. Most people nowadays simply Google trusted roofer, best roofer in the area, local roofer. And then you just start looking at the reviews. All of our emails, our documentations, our contracts, our authorization of insured forms, claim summaries, I mean, everything is digital. So it took a little bit, took several months to make the full transition and get everybody on track and fully. I mean, even now with how immersive we're using AccuLynx, we're maybe using it half of what it's capable of doing. But there's a definite push to have everything in one area and then allow everyone who needs access to have access. If an insurance company is paying for your roof, there's no reason to shop around based on cost. You should focus on shopping around based on quality, because the insurance company's job is to pay for what you have and for what's required under code. It's most advantageous for the homeowner to hire somebody that's licensed, has high accreditations and is accredited at a high level and that wants what they want, which is to do a great job so that we can get feedback and keep working in their communities. Before RoofMedic existed, I was bombarded with thoughts of why would anybody hire me? Why would anybody choose RoofMedic over the next person that's been in business longer? What can I offer that others can't? I'm not the best roofer in the world, but I'm a dang good one. And I know that the people and the customers that communicate with us, I believe they share my opinion because I care. And people typically want to do business with people they can tell care. The very first door I ever knocked on, and the homeowner answered, and she just in excited bewilderment, "Are you a roofer?" And I said, "Yes, ma'am." And she looked over her shoulder to her husband and screamed, "Honey, our lives are saved. We found one." And they were just so genuinely excited to not have to feel like their search was over.
I can't think of better ending for this video but to recognize all our veterans, people who serve this country. If you're in the roofing industry, please comment below. What do you do in the roofing industry? Are you the business owner? For our veterans, military personnel, if you serve this country, we wanted to get to know you. We read our comments. We want to recognize you, engage with you. Tell us about yourself. Tell us about what you do, about your experience, and give this video a like for Jordan, for all our hardworking veterans in the business. I know it can be challenging to adapt after you came back from your service, and on this channel we definitely want to become friends and support you in any way we can. If you want us to come to you, if you have good idea, amazing business, reach out. I'm gonna put all my information in description below. I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a good one.